Are you struggling to come up with original content week in and week out? Start a podcast. Interview your ideal clients, let them talk about what they care about most, and never run out of content ideas again. Learn more at sweetfishmedia.com.
You're listening to B2B Growth, a daily podcast for B2B leaders. We've interviewed names you've probably heard before, like Gary Vaynerchuk and Simon Sinek, but you've probably never heard from the majority of our guests. That's because the bulk of our interviews aren't with professional speakers and authors. Most of our guests are in the trenches leading sales and marketing teams. They're implementing strategy. They're experimenting with tactics. They're building the fastest growing B2B companies in the world. My name is James Carberry. I'm the founder of Sweetfish Media, a podcast agency for B2B brands, and I'm also one of the co-hosts of this show. When we're not interviewing sales and marketing leaders, you'll hear stories from behind the scenes of our own business. We'll share the ups and downs of our journey as we attempt to take over the world. Just kidding. Well, maybe. Let's get into the show.
Welcome back to the B2B Growth Show. I'm your host for today's episode, Logan Lyles. I am joined today by David Yahalom. He is the CTO and co-founder of NAYA TECH. David, how are you doing today, man?
I'm doing great, Logan. Thank you so much for having me.
Well, thank you for joining us. I am excited to hear your growth story today. We're going to hear some lessons learned in shifting your business model. Specifically, your team underwent a shift focusing on consulting services to creating a product out of the problem you saw in the market. Before we dig into some of those lessons today, David, I would love for you to share with the audience a little bit about what you and the team at NAYA TECH are up to these days.
So thank you, Logan. NAYA TECH, my company, was founded about 10 years ago as a database and data platform consulting and professional services firm. We specialize in providing expertise, consulting, professional services, turnkey project across most of the major database platforms and database technologies out there, such as Oracle, SQL Server, Postgres, MySQL. And myself personally, I started my career about 15 years ago as an Oracle DBA, and since then transitioned to different database platforms, different database technologies, and more recently, cloud and cloud migration.
I love it. Well, I appreciate that background, David. So let's jump right into this growth story. Really, you know, one of the things we were talking about offline before we hit record on this interview was using engineering as marketing. And I know the first thing you wanted to touch on that you guys encountered under this topic was, you know, trying to innovate to solve the unsolvable. Let's start there as we hear more about your story in making this pivot. What was it that you guys were trying to solve and some of the lessons in trying to innovate early on?
Well, it's actually a very interesting story. So as a database consulting services firm, a lot of what we do is cloud database migrations, which is essentially helping clients take their on-premise databases and migrate to the cloud while leveraging cloud-native solutions, enabling application modernizations, usually as part of a big digital transformation process. So traditionally, you know, this is a process that was done manually. When you do those cloud database migrations, you leverage, you know, your teams and your expertise and engage directly with clients. Some of them, you know, smaller SMB type clients, some of them large enterprises, but essentially it's a very manual process, starting with a migration assessment where you have to review, analyze, gather data about a fleet of on-prem databases. Could be tens of databases, hundreds of databases, or even thousands of databases. Analyze those databases and essentially create a migration plan. So again, this was a process that was done manually. It was cumbersome, to say the least, required a lot of back and forth with our clients. We had our database team send them scripts to run and commands to execute, which allow us to gather data, following which we had to formulate plans on how to migrate, which databases could be quick wins. Those plans usually were very low impact. So essentially, we created spreadsheets and Word documents. And again, this assessment process is essential for any cloud migration. It's the first step before you can actually move your systems to the cloud. Mm-hmm. But it was very cumbersome, very manual. and often tedious. You know, we used to joke and call it homework because we used to send our clients homework to do, run those scripts. Here are a bunch of questionnaires you have to fill out for us. And we even saw some of our clients, you know, as they were busy with their day-to-day activities, we saw some of their IT teams sometimes abandon the process midway. So it wasn't ideal. We were thinking about, you know, internally, we were brainstorming and thinking how we can innovate, how we can, you know, disrupt this aspect of the cloud migration market, specifically cloud migration assessments. And what we came up with, we said, hey, you know what? So maybe we can take all of our expertise, all of our knowledge, and turn that into a product that could maybe automate those cloud migration assessments. So instead of having to go through this manual process of collecting data and, you know, engaging back and forth with the clients, various stakeholders with each one of the organizations we work with, we said maybe we can just turn it into an automated product that can, you know, with a single click of a button, scan a fleet of on-prem databases, gather all of the information that we need, and also visualize it in a way that's very high impact. So mm-hmm. when we basically scan the on-prem databases, we can formulate migration plans, create dashboards and KPIs and charts, and essentially present our migration insights in a way that's valuable to both the technical aspects in the organization, but also to decision makers and you know, CIOs or EVPs that are responsible for the application modernization initiative within our clients. So we basically, what we did is turn a process that was manual and involved, like, you know, sending teams of people on site with the client, to a product called MIGVisor, stands for Migration Advisor, mm-hmm. which does all of that with essentially a click of a button.
Mm-hmm. So that sounds like a really big shift, David, going from, you know, this consulting service delivery mindset. You're trying to distill down all of your knowledge and expertise and put it into a product. When you were working with your clients to try and, you know, make this shift, where did you start out in trying to communicate the value to them, you know, in make that marketing shift of, you know, you have clients that know you as a service provider, and now you're offering them a product. Tell us a little bit about how you started to communicate that value as you made that shift.
Yeah. So the shift for us was, you know, substantial. As you said, Logan, we used to be purely a professional services firm, and transitioning, you know, pivoting into becoming also a product company. We still do a lot of PS. About 50% of our business is professional services and consulting, but the other half is now, you know, product driven, which was a big shift for us. So transitioning from a purely professional services and consulting firm into a company that also has a software and product division was was a big shift for us. So in terms of our clients, the value proposition is quite substantial. The process of those migration assessments traditionally used to take, you know, weeks, sometimes even months, requiring often, you know, we started doing it remotely, but often we had to send our teams on site with our clients. So the value proposition for our clients was, hey, let's start by using MIGVisor. Let's start by using our product. It's very easy. It's very low footprint. You don't need to install anything. You can just, you know, use it. It's a software as a service product. So it's a web-based product. And I think that when we suggested and presented our product to our clients, they kind of saw the value proposition immediately. For them, it saved them a lot of work they had to do themselves, you know, running the script, collecting the information, sending it back to us for review, and then having us send them a bunch of follow-up questions to something that's completely automatic. So I think that at least for us, the ability to show value to our clients was relatively immediate. So we didn't have to go through a long pre-sales process trying to convince our clients, hey, we have a product that might be useful for you. I think the value was pretty obvious from the get-go.
Mm-hmm. Was that tough for your organization to make that switch in the sales mentality of how you sold a product versus selling the service, and how you communicated it with the client, and what your approach was as you were selling and communicating the value prop to them as you made this shift, David?
Well, I think that the product is actually, you know, it has immense value for our clients, but for us, it also served as a pre-sales tool because, you know, when you compete in the market with other, you know, firms that provide consulting services and professional services in the database space. And, you know, plenty of consulting companies out there offer database migration consulting and database migration services to the cloud. It's an extremely, you know, hot topic right now. The fact that we have a product, which is, by the way, very unique, I don't think there is anything quite like it out there. The fact that we have a product from like our sales process perspective was a huge lead generator for us. In addition to clients, you know, licensing the product from us and buying it so that they can use it, when our pre-sales team and technical pre-sales resources engage with clients and told them, hey, you know, in addition to our consulting services, we also have this product which basically takes all of the knowledge that we have and basically distills it into a product that you can use yourselves, was immensely helpful. I think that when you engage in a technical pre-sales process with a prospect client and offer not just a service, but also a solution that involves a product, it helped us tremendously. And I think it made the pre-sales process, for us at least, easier. I think it helped us win, you know, deals and opportunities and even increase the credibility that we had in the eye of our customers.
All right, today's growth story is about search engine marketing. Clear Company is an HR tech company that was doing a lot of things right. Their messaging was clear, their product produced incredible results, but they were struggling to drive qualified traffic to their website. Then they found Directive Consulting, a B2B search marketing agency. Within the first 12 months of working with Directive, Clear Company was able to increase their qualified lead volume by 157%. I have a hunch that Directive can get these kind of results for you too. So head over to directiveconsulting.com and request a totally free custom proposal. That's directiveconsulting.com. All right, let's get back to this interview.
I think the big lesson here is in, you know, shifting your business model. As we mentioned a couple of times, there's a big shift for you guys. There's still services involved in your delivery, but having a product was never part of the mix before. David, what would you say to other founders of tech companies or founders that are, you know, trying to reach that next level of growth? Some of the lessons you've learned in making this shift. Do you think it's hard for founders to rethink their business model once they get to a certain stage?
Well, I think that it's very important to always be able to innovate and be able to reinvent yourself. I think that it was a big transition for us and it was a big shift, you know, both in terms of our vision, but also in terms of our day-to-day operations and execution. We had to you know, grow a software development arm within the company, which includes, you know, development and quality assurance and testing. We had to change our marketing language. We had to, you know, change even the way that we handle our sales process, because right now we have a product that we want to sell in addition to services. And we found that it's easier oftentimes to sell a product with some supplementary and complementary services, such as a product that does database migration assessment, with the migration process being offered as, hey, this is something else that you can also, you know, engage us to help you with. Mm-hmm. I think it was a big transition, but I would say to other founders out there, to other companies out there, that being able to understand what's the direction of the market, being able to reinvent yourself essentially and adjust your business model according to, you know, shift that's occurring in the market. For example, cloud database migration is an extremely hot topic right now. We see many of our clients who are traditionally, you know, running all of their systems on-premise in their own data center using physical or virtual hardware, engaged in, you know, a digital transformation process that leverages cloud migrations as a huge part of it. And this is a huge paradigm shift that's happening right now in the market. So for us, being able to identify it early on and say, hey, there is something that's going on in the market right now. There is a change in the way that our clients are running their databases and data platform. We need to think about how we can adjust our business model according to that and be able to maybe, you know, on some extent reinvent ourselves to be able to better provide services to our clients and to be able to have a solution out there that has more substantial value and a solution out there that can maybe disrupt the market that we operate in and, again, provide what I think is tremendous value to the organization that we work with. So for us, it was essentially a no-brainer to do this. And I would recommend other founders out there to always be able to reinvent themselves based on paradigm shifts that happen in the market and the direction the market is going.
Mm-hmm. I think that is a great point that really summarizes a key element of this story, David, is that, you know, as business leaders, we've got to continue to keep our finger on the pulse of the shifts that are happening in the problems that our customers are trying to solve. Because the more we focus on the problems they're trying to solve, the better we can think about innovating to solve those problems. And it might require a business shift. There might be some pain there. But, you know, as kind of you explained from your story, it actually benefited your business. It benefited sales by not having this 100% services model. The product kind of became a leader into more services revenue. So starting with figuring out the problems you're solving, innovating from there, you may need to adjust your business model, but there could be some benefits, even unforeseen ones, after making that shift. And again, better to be in front of the move in the market than behind it, right?
Yeah, Logan, I completely agree. And I think that, you know, me personally, you know, I always think, I think that innovation is something that's kind of tied very closely toward, you know, both technology and business. And I think that when you operate in a market, even if it's a mature market, you know, the database consulting market is a relatively mature market that is, you know, I've been doing what I'm doing for 15 mm-hmm. years now. And the company, my company has been, you know, providing database consulting services for a decade. But still, when we identify that there is an opportunity to disrupt the market, where we saw that maybe we can offer something that hasn't been done before, this, in addition to being technologically innovative, also is extremely helpful for our business. Because transitioning, I think that, you know, when we transition from, as you said, just being a purely services-oriented company to a company that also has a product portfolio, our products augment our services capabilities. And I think that, you know, leveraging both aspects together, having to being able to offer our clients a product and supplementary services, I think this is something that both our clients value. And from a sales and business perspective for us, it was tremendously successful.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. David, thank you so much for sharing the lessons you've learned in pivoting your business model today. If anybody listening to this would like to ask any follow-up questions or just stay connected with you, what would be the best way for them to go about doing that?
Oh, so first of all, you know, I would encourage people to reach out on LinkedIn. Also, you can visit our website, which is www.naya-tech.com, or we also have a separate website for our product, MIGVisor. So you can visit www.migvisor.com.
All right, David, thank you so much for coming on the show today. Really enjoyed the conversation.
My pleasure, Logan. Thank you so much for having me. Appreciate it.
Digital marketing agencies have a tough job. You have to stay on top of the latest marketing strategies for your clients and your agency. What if there was a way you could address both at the same time? Imagine your agency putting out content with greater quality and quantity. Envision bringing your clients a turnkey solution for one of B2B marketing's fastest growing media strategies, podcasting. You know all those clients asking for your help with their account-based marketing efforts? Picture being the first to bring them the idea of content-based networking, showing them the proven strategy for breaking into their most coveted accounts. Here's the concept. Sweetfish Media is looking to work with a limited number of innovative agencies interested in a new partnership model. We produce a podcast for your agency at no cost. You introduce the power of podcasting and Sweetfish services to your clients. Everybody wins. Learn more at sweetfishpartners.com.